Hey guys, what's poppin'? Jacques Slade here, back with another, well, not really an unboxing. This one's more like a hands-on of one of my favorite shoes, or I should say favorite collaborations that's come out this year, the Nike Cortez collaboration with Kendrick Lamar. Now, for a lot of you out there, you may think that the Nike Cortez is a new Nike shoe, but in fact, the Cortez was one of the first running shoes that Nike sold when the company launched back in 1972. Technically, the Cortez was a shoe actually sold by a Japanese brand called Onitsuka Tiger that was distributed by Blue Ribbon Sports, which is the company that Bill Bowerman and Phil Knight created back in the 60s before Nike. However, in 1971, that deal fell apart and prompted the start of the Nike that we know today. Back to the shoe, the Cortez has actually had a couple of different names. At one point, it was called the Mexico when it was a Tiger shoe. Then it was changed to the Aztec because they wanted a flashier name that would coincide with the Olympics. But then Adidas wasn't cool with that because they had a shoe called the Aztec. They sued Nike, so Nike ultimately changed the name of the shoe to the Cortez. Now, rumors say they started calling the shoe the Cortez after the conquistador Hernan Cortez, who defeated the Aztecs. Talk about being petty. Now, as you've seen, the original Cortez, it didn't look like the Cortez that we know and love today. The shoe didn't really start to look like the shoe that we know about until 1975, when Bowerman actually flipped the upper and made it nylon to make it lighter. It was at this point that I think the shoe started becoming popular with the general public and not just runners, and the shoe actually received a big boost when Farrah Fawcett wore the Cortez on an episode of Charlie's Angels back in 1977. From there, the shoe transitioned from performance to lifestyle and eventually made its way to LA, where it became a staple in the urban communities. Though they were definitely popular before NWA, I do remember seeing the shoes on the feet of the members of NWA in their music videos, and I think that's how it really became a big part of the culture. And to Kendrick's credit, I think that's where most of his inspiration for the shoe comes from as well. After that, the Cortez obviously continued to grow. It popped up in Forrest Gump, which was a huge moment for the shoe, and there have been a few different versions and iterations of the shoe since then, but none have really resonated as much, I believe, since Nike started collaborating with Kendrick Lamar. Now, the weird part is, because of the gang culture that the shoe was associated with, Nike has almost tried to ignore that part of its history, but with Kendrick and a couple of releases from 2017, it seems like they're kind of rearranging and switching up on that approach. Now, Kendrick's story and perspective is obviously inspired and shaped by those moments. It also shows that you're not limited by those moments, that you can grow from them. For this model in particular, it's tied to the TDE Championship Tour and rocks that black and white upper that was popular during the 80s. They've made a few changes, like the red strap on the tongue and on the heel, and they've also changed the stitching to red as well, which I think looks really dope. They definitely came in a nice box, and they have some damn inspired tissue paper as well. Now, as far as the details go, there are some instructions on the inside that tell you to wear the shoes with long socks and shorts, which is a very dope look. And if you look deep inside the shoe, you see the inside has the word Duckworth, which is Kendrick's actual last name, and a song on his damn album. Now, if you want to take it further, the song is about the encounter between Kendrick's father and his label boss, Anthony Top Dog, before he signed Kendrick to a record deal. And finally, there is some Chinese writing on the shoe that roughly translates to bet it back. Now, in addition to the shoes, Nike and TDE are also doing merch. I have the long sleeve t-shirt in red, and I have the sweatshirt here in black. Big thanks to the folks over at Nike for sending those over. Kendrick happens to be one of my favorite artists, and to see him collaborate with the brand in this way that doesn't really compromise is pretty dope in my opinion. Now, retail for this pair of the Cortez Kenny 3 is $100, and these are currently sold out, but I have a feeling that Nike, TDE, and Kung Fu Kenny have a few more things coming down the pipeline. I just want to say thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed. I'm Jacques Slade. If you like what you see, feel free to subscribe, and as always, I appreciate you. All right, guys, I'll see you soon. Peace.